Good day. Today is December 3, 2019, 9:39 PM. So update tayo sa ginawa nating POS system using C# and SQL Server database. Okay, so last time, so gumawa tayo ng validation dito sa ating product. Say for example, pag bumili tayo dito ng so, meron tayong available to quantity and then bili tayo ng tatlo. So, ayan. So, hindi na siya pwede kasi nilagyan natin siya ng validation. Okay. So, same with the barcode. Okay. So, this time, so, lagyan natin ng function itong mga shortcut keys natin dito. So, for example, if 1 for the new transaction, if 2 search product, if 3 a discount, if 4, settle payment hanggang dito kay F10. Okay? So, dito tayo kay POS, FRM POS. So, under sa FRM POS, ayan. So, dito sa ating constructor, so, nilagyan natin siya ng this dot key preview equal to true. Okay? And then, punta tayo dito kay form. So, select the form. FRM POS. And then, punta tayo dito kay methods. So, select natin si key down. So, key down. Okay. So, condition tayo dito if a dot key code is equal to case dot if one. Okay. Okay, and then tatawagin natin, invoke natin itong si BTN, balik tayo sa property. Okay, so back to property. Then, so BTN, yung name ng ating button is BTN new. Okay. And the BTN new, and then we have the sender. Okay, so try natin run the program. So if 1 tayo, if 1, so ayan, so automatic yung transaction number. Okay, and then balik tayo, if 2 bit inserts, so condition naman tayo dito, else if equal to if 2, and then it inserts if 3 btn discount btn setup if 7 tayo. So this is if 3 btn discount pa yata ang kung si discount Okay, so this is button 2. So button 2. Yeah, so this is button 2. And button 2. Button to click is a sender in E. Double sky cable is 4. So this is it all. Then set all. Okay, so try natin. Cashier 1 2 3 4. Okay, so if one if two search ayan, tapos example just click natin to isa. Okay, tapos ito click natin isa, tapos a discount if 3 for adding discount. Okay, tapos for settle payment if 4. Okay, ayan. Okay, so dito sa ating source product if 2, so pag kinancel natin to, so dapat ma-close na itong form natin. So, ang gagawin natin is dito tayo kay BTN lookup. So look up natin, F7 natin. So dito lagyan natin siya ng this dot key preview equal to true. Okay, tapos punta tayo dito kay form look up and then event, then search natin si key down. Okay, so condition natin dito if e dot key code is equal to case dot escape. Okay, and then this dot dispose. Check natin cashier. So example if 1 and then if 2 escape. Okay, if 2 and then escape. Okay, same with the discount. So sa discount natin, okay, natin dito with that key, you know, is the key preview equal to true, then go to event, click natin si key down. If e dot then this dot dispose, so copy na lang natin to. The payment see, I mean, so see it all. So see it all natin, and that give preview is equal to true. Tapos punta tayo ng event and then key down. Okay, so yan, lagyan na natin siya ng shortcut case. Cashier 1, 2, 3, 4. If 1, if 2. Skip. Ayan. Then if 3, a discount. Skip. If 4, example 6,000. Okay. So, enter natin. So, lagyan rin natin ng shortcut key itong enter natin. Okay? Para hindi na kailangan mag press pa ng enter button. Okay, so again, sa CTOL, then your BTN enter. Else if we dot so pag enter natin, process natin si BTN, enter, click sender E. Okay. Cashier 1, 2, 3, 4. So try natin if 1, if 2. Bili tayo ng isa. Skip. If 4. Skip. If 4. Tapos 1,000. Then enter. Okay. So ayan, meron tayong mga shortcut keys dito. So, ganun rin to sa ating key preview. So, lagyan natin ang shortcut. I mean, sa print preview. So, dito. Dito rin. Lagyan rin natin to. Place that key preview true. And then select the form, then go to methods, then select natin key down. If a dot key code is equal to keys dot escape this dot dispose. Okay, so ayan, lagyan na natin siya ng shortcut case. Pili tayo ng dalawa. Tapos, if for natin si told. So 520, enter. Okay. So again, this is a simple, I just want to remind you guys, this is a simple Pearson inventory system. So, kung in-expect nyo is sobrang laki ng system na to. So, this is only for the beginners na gusto or willing to learn on how to program POS and inventory system using C# and SQL Server Database. So, again, thank you for watching. So, until sa ating next tutorial. So again, as I said, last video. So, ang gawin natin is alternate yung tutorial natin. So, tutorial for C#, then the other D is tutorial naman for VB.NET. Okay? So, again, so maraming salamat sa iyong panonood. And, have a good day.